Another thing about Dak Prescott that we need to mention here, and this is part of something that he's been very involved in. He lost a brother to suicide last year. He's been wearing, as someone noted on social media, "Ask for Help" written on his wrist tape this year to support mental health awareness. And I understand that the full stigma of issues with anxiety, depression, non-physical injuries, the full stigma has yet to disappear, but we're making a hell of a lot of progress. And I'm encouraged by the fact that people are no longer ashamed to the point that they're paralyzed with silence by the issues. And I think the more that we talk about it, that first step is always the hardest one, especially for men, the way men are wired.
That's
to internalize, to fight through it, to
be tough.
Yeah, it's a sign of weakness.
Right.
Come on, we're all human. Regardless of who we are, regardless of what gender we are, we're all human, and we need to understand that there are times that we need help. And this stupid bravado that too many men carry around, that they're in some way giving up their alpha. Don't want to be a beta. Got to be an alpha. Can't admit that I ever have an issue. That would make me a beta. That's bull. I almost said the other word. So when you need help, get help. When you need to talk to somebody, find somebody. And be that person who's always probing the people in your life. If you're fine, number one, thank your lucky stars every day if you're fine and you don't have these issues, because I think we all have them at some point in our lives. But when you are in a situation where you are fine, be sensitive to all the people you interact with, because you never know who that one person is that needs help, that is teetering on the brink of not asking for it, and maybe you can be the one who initiates the conversation to get them to ask for help. So that's an obligation that we all share as we fulfill our obligation to take care of each other, plain and simple.
Chris. Yeah, no, you're 100% right. I mean, that's why it's great that Dak Prescott, we've seen so many athletes over, I feel like, the last year and a half, 2 years, come out and address some of these issues. And I do think it, you know, to what you're saying, like, I do think it encourages men especially. Yeah, I don't know what it is about us that we, you kind of explained it, we're just so stubborn that way. And I mean, I know I have somebody I talk to from time to time, and sometimes I got to talk to them a little bit more than maybe other times. You get lost in your own brain, your stupid private logic, things you're dealing with in life. You don't know if you're dealing with them the right way. There's nothing wrong with going to see somebody who knows how the brain works, knows, you know, psychology, you know, social patterns, everything there, that, yeah, it helps you. And I was stubborn. I was one of those guys, too. When my wife used to tell me to go talk to somebody, I was like, oh, be quiet. I don't want to hear it from you. I'm fine. All right. I'll figure it out. I'll deal with it, blah, blah, blah. But you don't deal with it. You end up just making the problem worse by avoiding it and swiping it under the rug all the time. And it's really good to see people like Dak Prescott kind of at the front of the line, you know, leading the charge on this discussion.
Especially because it spurs others to notice it,
Definitely.
To talk about it,
That's
and
it.
To send
right.
the message. So thank you, Dak Prescott, for
go,
having
Dak.
That message on your tape. It gave us an opportunity
My man,
to spend
Dak.
Some time talking about it. And here's how I look at it, Chris.
Yeah.
You know, I don't know how many people watch the show live on Peacock. I don't know how many people watch the re-air on NBCSN. I don't know how many listen to the podcast. I don't know. But I know, based upon the emails that I get, that there's plenty of people out there who pay attention to what we say.
Definitely.
And if this 5 minutes we've spent gets one person who feels lost in the weeds to do what they need to do, what they don't want to do, what they don't think they should do, what they think is not strong or tough or manly to do, if it gets them to do it, then it's worth the time spent. It's worth spending the whole show on the issue if it convinces one person to do it.
Hi, I'm Mike Tirico, and thanks for watching. Make sure to hit subscribe for the latest news and highlights from NBC Sports.